Spread across 168 acres in Smyrna sits the home and farm of Confederate soldier Sam Davis.
After his death, his home really became a symbol of his memorial, of his bravery during the Civil War.
But what folks will find on the property may be more than the original woodwork and furniture from the 19th century.
Not only visitors, but employees here that have had encounters with something.
That something.
I have heard the footsteps and the doors closing, but it never seems to be anyone there.
Hard to explain, even for the home's executive director, Jenny Lamb.
I just can't quite put my finger on who they are.
From the 1800s up until the 1920s, Davis and his family called the property home. They farmed on over 2,000 acres of land.
They were not only large landholders, but slaveholders, owning 51 slaves by the 1860 census.
The room Davis shared with his brother John, still furnished with their beds, clothes, and toys before they went off to war in the 1860s.
After just a short time as a soldier in the Army, he was recruited into an elite group known as Coleman Scouts.
Davis and his fellow scouts worked as spies, collecting intelligence from the Union Army. Just a few years later, in 1863, federal troops captured Davis near Minor Hill. His fate, death by hanging. The Union offered to spare his life if he revealed his sources.
He bravely refused and therefore died at the young age of 21.
That bravery earning Davis the title of Boy Hero of the Confederacy. His body was eventually brought home to Smyrna, now buried in the family cemetery where his spirit is said to make itself known. Our encounter captured on audio as our camera rolled on Sam Davis's headstone.
That was creepy, wasn't it?
That was freaking scary.
I try to process what has just happened.
And after today, I do believe that it is true. Sam Davis's spirit is on this property. I was standing over there by the cemetery, just 15 yards away from this very spot, when a branch fell from overhead and snapped into 6 pieces.
Our encounter now added to the most mysterious sights and sounds on the property. But it doesn't end there.
Tall, slender man with a long beard. He's been seen looking out of windows.
There are also stories of a little boy in the house who disappears, and a lady in green.
She's supposedly wearing a green dress from the 19th. Thought that she must be a tour guide here, but none of our tour guides wear period clothing.
Although much remains a mystery, call the property home.
There's this, you know, wonderful sense of
Lamb says the spirits who may still call the property home.
There's this full sense of calm on this property and in this house
are a special connection to the past she hopes will be present for many more generations to come. Linda Ong, News 2.